We get to our archive feature now, when we trawl through all those interviews that the BBC keep. They lost a lot, but they kept a few. We go back to the 4th of February, 1978. That's 37 years ago this Wednesday, when the Radio 1 programme Rock On celebrated the band The Rich Kids as they had chart success with their self-titled single. The group featured Midge Ure, yet to form Ultravox, also Rusty Egan, and a guy called Glen Matlock, who was the original bass player with the Sex Pistols, is credited with co-writing 10 of the 12 songs on the Sex Pistols album, but when the album was released, he quit the band, and Sid Vicious took over as bass player. For the Rock On programme, John Tobler spoke to Glen Matlock about how the group came together and how they began making music. And I love this. It's sort of like a pantomime, really, when John Tobler say, "Well, you're really successful now." "Oh, no, I'm not." "Oh, yes, you are."
When you started all this, Glen, did it occur to you that you would achieve the success that you've achieved as quickly as this?
I don't really know that I've achieved that much success at the moment. I think I haven't really done much at all.
Well, you're at number 24 or whatever it is in the chart. I mean, that's more success than 90% of groups ever achieve.
Yeah, but then look at 90% of most other groups.
Oh, dear.
When you started this, you already had Steve and Rusty for some considerable time, but can you tell us a story about how you eventually found Midge and the problems you had?
Well, it was kind of a bit disappointing in a way, because I met Steve and Rusty immediately. I split the Pistols, and because all that was so kind of right from the beginning, anything that took any time after that was a real disappointment and a letdown. And he was always trying out loads and loads of people, auditioning guitarists and singers and all that, and nobody was any good. And I just went out for a walk in Leicester Square, to just walk straight out to the rehearsal studio. He was trying this guy out, and I walked into a music shop, and there was Slick's album there, and I thought, that's the guy. Just like
did you immediately say yes, or did you think about it for quite a long time?
No, I was intrigued. I was knocked out with the idea, like, you know, an ex-Pistol getting together with an ex-Slick. Well, I wasn't an ex-Slick at the time, but, you know, just the two of us from supposedly opposite ends of the scale getting together and forming a band. I mean, that appealed to me. It appealed to my sense of humour. So I went down for a weekend to see Glen and Steve and Rusty. And what I found was, like, three guys with no money, nowhere to live, telling me how good they were going to be if I joined the band, and they were going to do this and going to do that. No management, no nothing. No organisation, mainly. So, a lot of ideas and a few good songs, but that was about it. The basics were them. So I went back up to Scotland after a couple of days, and we did a couple of gigs the weekend I was down. And then decided a few months later that the best thing for any of us to do in Slick to further our careers was to split and go on separate ways. And luckily the position hadn't been filled with Rich Kids, so we got together.
Around me, they are stumbling.
Both the band and the song called Rich Kids. Before we heard some chat from Midge Ure and Glen Matlock of the band. That was in 1978. A year later, the group broke up. Glen Matlock went on tour with Iggy Pop, while Midge Ure joined a certain band by the name of Ultravox.